Hi, today I'm going to show you a simple salad. Always I have people asking me, my clients, friends, asking me how to make an interesting salad dressing. What I want to say is you don't have to make a fancy salad dressing. You can just use a couple of ingredients very comfortably in your own house and make a wonderful salad dressing that perks up your salad. Here today we are going to show, I'm going to make sesame and lemon dressing with sesame seeds on it. This is how you start. Any salad, how you want to make for home, is that you don't want to make salad dressing in another bowl and then transfer to this, the main bowl. What you can do is you can already start making a dressing into the bowl and then start adding ingredients into it. Here we're making an Asian salad with all the ingredients that are locally available. We start with making a salad dressing. I like to use my lemons peel as well for its zest. It smells awesome. You can have one of these simple micropane peelers and just go like this. Make sure that you don't use, you don't peel, you don't grate into the white pith. It is bitter. It'll become, your salad dressing become bitter. Whereas just the lemon peel will give this nice aromatic flavor to your dressing. There we go. Now we've peeled, we've gotten all the peel out. There's your lemon juice. Would have been nicer if this was a deeper bowl, but this works just fine. And then you want to use a little sesame oil. There we go, 2 spoons. Remember though, sesame seeds are excellent for health. It has a lot of calcium, a lot of protein, a lot of B vitamins, a lot of minerals. It takes about 1/2 cup of sesame seeds to make 1 spoon of oil. So use your oil sparingly and use your seeds liberally. We're going to use the seeds as well later. We're going to use 2 kinds of sesame seeds, the black sesame and the white sesame. They both have similar nutritive value, except that one is obviously the color. Also, one is a little more bitter than the other. So you watch which one you want to use the most. So here we have lemon juice from 1/2 lemon, 1 spoon of oil, some salt. So here we have some lemon, some sesame oil, 1 spoon of sesame oil, some lemon zest, and a little bit of sea salt. This is Himalayan rock salt. And some freshly ground black pepper. There we go, it's too tight. There. And if you like it spicy, for this salad, a green hot chili is very yummy. So we're gonna chop up a little bit of this. And then you can start with a cabbage. This cabbage looks different than what we're used to here, but it is just the same. A friend grew it, so I'm going to use it here. Cut it off. Cabbage is quite tasty on its own. It's a wonderful cruciferous vegetable. It's anti-cancerous. It has loads of antioxidants, and it prevents. It's also excellent for diabetes. Anything that's green with a lot of fiber is super good for diabetes. It helps insulin production. So go like this. And then we add some grated carrot. This is season for these red carrots now. These are red carrots from up north. They're much sweeter than the regular orange variety. So here we are. And use one of these graters. So it's, now we have vegetables. I want to make it rich, like a meal. I want to add things that have a lot of protein to make it substantial. So here I have cabbage, carrot. Cabbage is sort of marinating in the oil and lemon. And here we have cucumber. See, now we have a vegetable salad here. Now if I wanted to make it as a meal, I would like to add some substantial ingredients into it. Here we have sprouts. Mung bean sprouts are one of the easiest ones to sprout, loaded with nutrients, a lot of protein. A lot of people say, oh, if I eat beans and legumes, I have bloating and gas forming. Not with sprouts. Chew them and drink a lot of water throughout the day. There we go. Full. It has complete protein. Complete protein. It has all the essential amino acids in them. There we go. And I also grow sunflower sprouts. Sunflower sprouts, in my opinion, are the tastiest sprouts on earth. They taste like sunflower seeds, actually, and they're super, super easy to grow. And now I'm gonna add some black sesame seeds and some white sesame seeds to add to not only to the taste of it, but add protein, calcium, and other vital minerals and vitamins into it. There we go. This will also taste great in the dressing if you were to add some ginger juice. Just simply take a piece of ginger, grate on this, just squeeze out, and there you'll have a little variety of dressing. Cilantro, coriander will be great as well on this. Otherwise, it's yum just like this. Yeah, just. So to add to the crunch of the salad and for the protein and taste, I'm also going to use some almonds. These almonds are already soaked and dried, so the nutrients in them are easily available to your body. Here, I'm just going to make little pieces of these. Just drop them. It looks pretty, it'll be tasty. Almonds are nice and sweet as well as crunchy. Here we go. Okay, here we have our salad. Let me give it a taste. So here we have a wonderful salad that we made in a few minutes. It takes hardly few ingredients to make this exciting salad. So we can call this a superfood salad because all the ingredients in them, most of the ingredients in here are considered superfoods. We have cabbage that is these are cruciferous vegetables that are anti-cancerous. We use cabbage here. We used carrots. We used sweet deli carrots that are loaded with beta carotene, very good for eyes. And also this is preventative. We have sprouts. Sprouts are also considered superfoods because superfoods are nothing but foods that have lots of nourishment in them, within them. They're not just foods, they're superfoods because they have so much in them. I used sunflower sprouts as well, homegrown. They're super tasty and highly, highly blood sugar regulating. We could use this salad as a meal together with some millet rotis, or with some brown rice or red rice, it would make a meal. Or you could, if you're a non-vegetarian, you could eat it with a piece of fish that is steamed or grilled. It's your choice. Enjoy. Okay, tip of the day today is this. Did you know that it takes half a cup of sesame seeds to make one spoon of oil? Imagine how much enjoyment you can get from eating half a cup of sesame seeds. I can think of like 10 different ways right now to enjoy sesame seeds. You can make it into balls together with dates. You can just eat them as they are. You can make dressings with them. You could powder them and use them on your salads or your rice dishes or idlis or whatever that might be. So there's hundreds of uses to use sesame seeds and enjoy them. Whereas if you were to use oil, one spoon of oil goes really nowhere, and it adds up to calories, a lot of calories if you were to use a lot more of them. So choose your foods wisely, always use whole foods. They'll give you most amount of nutrition for what you consume. Hi, this is Sridevi, holistic nutritionist at Vibrant Living Foods. Hope you enjoyed my recipe here. And you'll try it at home. If you have any questions, please comment down there. I will respond to you in my next video. Thank you.